Well.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the second part where we have left. That is, first let us recapitulate what we have done in the previous class. In the previous class, we have learned about land resource. Land is a resource where maximum number of people live, the uneven distribution of population. Then we have also learned about the land use. That how the land is being used. You remember that the land was not used properly, and we have also learned how better we will distribute or how better we will use the land. Then we have also learned about the common property resources. Then we have learned about that we have to conserve the land. We have learned that how we can conserve the land. We can make a map, we can draw diagrams where we can utilize what kind of land. Then we have also learned that what are the mitigation mechanisms for landslides. First we have learned about what are landslides. Then we have learned about what are the mitigation mechanisms. So some of the mitigation mechanisms were like some of the mitigation mechanisms were like barriers. We will put on barriers, we grow more trees, there will be hazard mapping. Now, then we have started our topic, that was the soil, and we have learned what is soil, and the soil has a parent rock. What is a parent rock? Parent rock is a big boulder. That is when, suppose a big boulder is then subdivided, like it is broken, sentences, and then over the top, it goes on to become a soil. So for example, here we will talk about, first it is a parent rock, then it becomes, can anybody say what it becomes? It becomes weathered rock material, weathered rock material. Then it becomes your subsoil with sand silt and clay. Subsoil with sand, silt and clay. Then what it becomes? After that, when you mix our humus with it, it becomes the topsoil with humus and the best way for plant. That is the humus soil. So this is how our whole soil forms. First it is a parent rock, then the weathered rock. Weathered means when the parent rock has been broken into bits and pieces. Then it is a subsoil. Our big sentence is okay. When the weathered rock, big boulders are there, small pebbles are there in the middle rocks. And then it becomes your subsoil. And then it becomes your soil, it is a humus soil. After that, we are going to find what are the factors of soil formation. When I talk about the factors of soil formation, the first factor, that is the parent rock. It has to have a parent rock. Yes, it has that determine the color, texture, chemical properties, and mineral content. It determines what? The color, the texture, and the chemical properties. Now, if a parent rock is in Rajasthan, Rajasthan has red soil. So, what will be the soil type? If the parent rock is red, so the soil will be red in color. Now, it is a black soil. The parent rock is black in color. It will be a black soil. So, the parent rock actually determines what kind of soil it will be. Then it comes the climate. Because if it is rain season, then what will happen? Continuously rain will drop it. And what will happen? If the continuous rain will drop it, then your parent rock will break. So, in areas like in polar areas, there's hardly rainfall. There's hardly proper soil that is being found. More and more you find the what? More and more? Yes, more and more. how the soil is formed. Last thing we must see that the soil is being degraded day by day. So it is not being degraded. So we have to conserve the soil. The quality of conservation depends upon this thing. We have to practice mulching, controlled burial, rock damp, terrace farming, intercropping. What is mulching? Mulching the bare ground between plants. Mulching is like there will be a bare ground like this. There will be not, and the straws will be put right so that the soil doesn't get, it is not eroded from that place. That is what mulching. What is contour barrier? In the mountains, anybody that can tell about contour barrier? Contour barrier is when it's a mountain, so that the rock, the sand doesn't get eroded, they put on contours like this. They put on contours like this and make sure the soil is not eroded. What is terrace farming? Terrace farming is similar to contour barrier. We don't need to make contours, we plant trees here. In terrace farming, what we do? We plant trees like this and crops. We plant trees and crops. So that is not terrace farming. What happens in intercropping? In this intercropping, we plant different types of crops. It's not one crop at a time. We plant different. Intercropping is different types of plants, different type of crops that we plant. Last but not least, we will come on to water. Now, water is one resource that is getting here, that is getting very lessened day by day. So what we have to make, we have to make sure that the water is not contaminated, and first of all, that water can be available to every one of us. Now there is scarcity of water everywhere around the world, and there are more than 7 billion people that is dependent on water, and there is 1.2 billion of people who doesn't get proper water to drink. What is the problem of water? The problem is we don't use it efficiently. We don't use it efficiently. So what we have to do, we have to make sure that we use it efficiently. We use it very, very efficiently. How can we use it? Use less amount of water. What do you do? Use less amount of water. Use less amount of water. Use less amount of water. Then what you can do? You can use your cars. You can wash your cars with very less amount of water. You can make sure that the clothes are damp, and then you can make sure that the clothes are wet one day at a time so that the water can be saved. Make sure that your taps are being properly switched off. This is some of the way that we can conserve water. So, what did we study today? We studied first of all the practice of soil formation and recapitulation. Then we have studied about the balance of climate, rain, time, how time is important, how a parent shock is important, like if a parent shock is black in color, then the soil will be also black soil. Then we have studied about how we can save and we can conserve the soil. First of all, it is mulching, then control barriers, long term, terrace farming, intercropping. This is the way that we can conserve the soil. We have also studied about water, its problems, and how can we conserve it. So there's a question that I want to put to you then from the next class, that you come with the best possible way of conserving water in around your area. And in the next class, we will also start a class with distribution of natural vegetation